Hi everyone, and welcome to Not the Talyllyn Railway. We're just not in Towyn today. We're in Birmingham for the Heritage Railway Association Awards for this year. So, gathered in this room right now is a massive chunk of all the heritage railways in the UK. This is a pretty big thing, so we'll pop in and we'll see how the awards go.
The Heritage Railway Association is actually the UK trade association for heritage railways, tramways, rolling stock preservation group, cliff railways, related museums and so on. It's really important. It's really, really important because actually there's a lot of work to do in places like Parliament. In fact, the four parliaments in Westminster, in the Senate, in Wales, in Scotland, in Northern Ireland, to support politically heritage railways. We have to talk to other businesses. We talk to the media. We work with the regulator. So we are representing heritage railways and tramways in a whole variety of different ways, supporting them. And of course, we put on events like this. We've just had a two-day conference tackling some really big issues. And the conference is aimed at boards, trustees, chairmen, senior managers, talking about governance, talking about how we get more young people involved, talking about safety issues, also looking at some of the positive stuff. What are the forward stats for the visitor economy for 2023? And the weekend has culminated in a terrific awards evening where we're recognising on behalf of the sector all those people, those individuals who do great things. And wow, we've had some wonderful nominations. As the host, Paul Lewin, said this evening, actually everyone's a winner. Of course, there's always some of the edges in each category and gets there. But the awards are a really important reflection of how much progress the heritage rail sector has made and all the great stuff we do. And reverting back to what I said earlier on, that actually helps me because I can talk to a politician and go, yeah, do you know, we're not just train spotters. There's some really big work going on. We're part of the UK's cultural heritage. And just to explain that in a nutshell, Flying Scotsman, we all know it, that's as recognisable globally as Big Ben. Flying Scotsman is mobile heritage, Big Ben is built heritage. We are really important and the HRA backs it and leads it all the way.
Distinguished guests, fellow footplate brethren, a very good evening to you all and welcome to the Heritage Railway Association annual dinner and awards ceremony. So the time has come now to start talking about awards. So our first award this evening is the Award for Business Innovation. I have here the golden envelope. And for the first time this evening, I can reveal that the winner is... They told me to do this slowly to build tension. The Bodmin and Wentford Railway. This is the longest standing and possibly the most respected of the awards that we present this evening, the Coyley Award for Steam Locomotion. And so the winner of the Coyley Award for Steam Locomotion is Sittingbourne of Kemsley Road. Our next award is the HRA Award for Diesel and Electric Locomotion. And the winner is GeoRail for the Andrew Barclay Restoration Project. And next we have the Award for Marketing and Communications. We tweaked it again to broaden the range of work that it covers because now more than ever, marketing and communications are so important and there's such a breadth of things that have to be covered by all our heritage railways in order to promote our activities and bring those activities to the world's attention. I think that this year more than ever, we've seen some fantastic entries and particularly video. People are using video a lot more, and so we've been having to look at how people are using video and how powerful it is. So a very interesting set of awards to judge. Some very competent entries for this award, which include the Talyllyn Railway, the Gloucestershire and Warwickshire Steam Railway, and the Isle of Wight Steam Railway. So let's have a look at what they've been up to.
Spurred on by the need to alter its marketing during the pandemic, the Talyllyn Railway, the world's oldest preserved railway, has now built a digital audience, having successfully moved from traditional marketing channels, expanding into video production as a key form of external marketing. Channel analytics show that the videos were viewed over 737,000 times during 2022. Island Rail News is a members' full-colour A4 magazine published four times a year. Featuring a balance of current news from across the railway's principal departments, coupled with historic articles and features relating to the island's once extensive railway system, Island Rail News continues to play a key role in communicating with members and supporters and promoting the Isle of Wight Steam Railway's activities. Broadway Museum and Gloucestershire and Warwickshire Steam Railway have collaborated to provide a cross-market visitor-focused exhibition of steam, evoking the nostalgia of a bygone era. Marketing the exhibition has been managed jointly using social media to its fullest extent, with imagery and film clips to engage the audience, resulting in hits with the best performing posts generating over 1,000 video views.
A good selection of projects. I'm sure, actually, if you thought about it in this room, there are many more that could have submitted an entry for this award. Many railways are doing some really good work with their marketing and communications. But we have a good selection of projects. I know from my own personal experience, you know, when working in front of camera, just how much genuine engagement you can get with your audience. But I also know how much effort goes into getting it right. So I think that the winners of tonight's award can be very proud of the effort that they've put in there. And the winner of the Marketing and Communications Award is Talyllyn Railway. Yeah. To remind everybody that Stuart Williams can't be here with us tonight because he's in the Out Hebrides or something like that. He's sold his soul and gone and worked for a different kind of organisation altogether. However, Stuart Williams was the leader of the Talyllyn Railway that helped start all this programme off, and we're very grateful to him for his input. Although, frankly, I'm grateful not to have to watch any more of him talking on videos. This is the HRA Award for rising stars. So who did the judges go with? Kerry Noble, West Somerset Railway. Back down to earth now with the Infrastructure Award. The HRA Award then for Infrastructure goes to the Hampton and Kempton Waterworks Railway. So this is the Morgan Award for Rolling Stock Preservation. And so, please, can you, as modern parlance says, give it large for the winner, which is the Lincolnshire Coast Light Railway for the Queen Mary. The 11th award this evening is for Environmental Innovation. The winner of the HRA Award for Environmental Innovation goes to the North Yorkshire Moors Railway. The The 12th award this evening is the Team of the Year award. There was a clear winner, and that winner is the Peak Rail Volunteer. So our next award is the Steam Railway Magazine Award.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. So as you know, the Steam Railway Magazine Award is, we choose 10 projects that have been completed throughout the last calendar year, and we offer it to our readers to decide what the winner should be. It is the only award decided among the HRA awards by the general public. There was a huge range of projects, and whittling the shortlist down to just 10 projects was incredibly difficult. We never know what to get, what we're going to get from our voters, and we have been incredibly surprised. Sometimes there are clear winners, sometimes it can be a sling and match right until the very end. We had over 4,000 people voting, and it was very, very, very close. We are delighted to announce that the Talyllyn Railway for the Tidal Watering Project has won the Steam Railway Greens Award 2023.
Award, and because we are so impressed by those who've been shortlisted, all will receive a special commendation certificate from HRA. But we have chosen a winner to take forward the light of the HRA in the coming year. And I'm delighted to say that that's Oliver Harrison from the Keithley and Worth Talyllyn. So if 14 awards weren't enough, there's just one remaining category, and arguably it's the biggest and best one. And so the 2023 Railway of the Year Award, sponsored by Hallett Oils, goes to the Isle of Wight Steam Railway. Well, folks, according to my script, it's time to draw matters to a close and go to the bar unless Steve Oates gets up and says something different. Steve.
Well, there is something different. Yeah, Paul, don't go too far away. I'm not just gatecrashing here, because while you think this is the last award, and we have said there's 15 awards, we do actually just have one more. The HRA 2023 Manistee Award for Excellence to the Festiniog Railway for its Gravity Train Project.
They're my boys. Oh, goodness me. Well, what a fantastic way to round off a night. And congratulations again to everybody who's made the shortlist. Tonight has demonstrated that despite all of the challenges, and boy, do we hear a lot about that, that we're still doing an enormous amount of things that are really good in the heritage sector. Thank you to all the railways whose names you've heard and seen this evening. Their dedication and their efforts are a living example to everybody who cares about this country's cultural heritage. And our heritage railways, which make the UK's heritage railway is frankly the best in the world. Just remains to say before we go off to the bar, keep doing all these great things, encourage other people to do great things. Keep restoring, keep encouraging young volunteers, keep building great teams, keep looking after the environment, looking for new business opportunities and constructing carriage sheds, very important. And please, please make sure we have a really good crop of entries for the awards for 2024. Good luck to you all for this season and good night.